They who have been together as friends and a this for a long time,
see separation in individual paths ahead. They who have hopefully grown physically, emotionally, socially, psychologically, and spiritually will face the test of new growth, intellectually and economically. They whose self-confidence is intact and healthy will have to test the new trust in your surrounding new school and work. They who have been practiced in leadership and found themselves mentoring and modeling for younger students will now need to support each other as they become beginners again and search for role models and worthy leaders in their turn. Loving God, bless all of us here present. Bless the families of these graduates. Bless their classmates and counterparts across the country. Give them confidence in your love. Give them strength in your power. Give them humility in your trust, and give them gratitude for their many friends, and give them love and peace in their parental homes. Amen.
Members of the school board, Fridley High School administration, faculty, parents, relatives, and friends. On behalf of the graduating class of 1991, we welcome you tonight. We are glad that you are here to celebrate this important milestone with us. We have worked hard to reach this point, and you have worked hard to get us where we are tonight. We thank you for your support, your encouragement, your influence, your example. We appreciate you, and again, welcome.
I'd like to thank the Academy, my mom, my dad, my stepdad, my grandparents who came out here to LA all the way from Montana, my brother, mentor, and my hero, Marshall, and the entire cast of Dances with Wolves. Oh, dang it, wrong one. I'm sorry, hold. Well, the administration warned me against using this time for personal purposes, but before I begin the address, I have some last-minute business to take care of. If you could all just sit tight for a minute. Kim Carlson, I have that dollar you loaned me for lunch last year. You can pick it up after the exercises. Sorry, I'm a little bit late on that. Dan Newport, you loaned me $5 when we were a sophomore. Yeah, I got that here. Mike Hermanson, my next-door neighbor in lockers for 6 years. On eighth grade, you loaned me a Fridley middle school pencil. I'm sorry, I don't know what happened to it, but there it is. You guys can pick these up afterwards. Cully Johnson, he left a notebook at my house in fifth grade. Remember that handwriting assignment you never turned in? It's in there, sorry. And finally, when we went to the Science Museum of Minnesota in third grade, Ryan Peterson, your mom loaned me 30 cents so I could buy some magnets in the gift shop. And thanks a lot, with interest. And with that, ladies and gentlemen, my high school career is finished. When I first found out last fall that I was the lucky one voted to speak, I thought, if I'm going to do this, I'm not going to settle for one of those run-of-the-mill, let's reflect speeches. The only time that I really feel comfortable is when I'm in front of a lot of people. So as long as I'm here, I'm going to talk about things that I really care about. I'm going to talk about what I think, which they say is a big no-no, and I'm going to go out on a limb and do this my way. Which, incidentally, would make a great title for a song. I've always liked the stage, a big audience in front of me, and the knowledge that I can do whatever I want, and nobody can stop me. My mother heard the news, and she gave me some good public speaking advice. She said to me, "Kendall, don't embarrass me." I said, "Now, how am I going to know if I'm embarrassing you or not?" So I worked out this simple plan. If anything weird happens tonight up here, just feel free to stare in her direction. She's right over there. Hopefully this will run on an even keel, and that won't be necessary any more than, say, 5 or 6 times. But please realize, whatever happens tonight, I did this my way. I'm sorry, I'm thinking of something else. Never mind. Regarding the speech, somebody said to me, "So you're going to make us laugh? You're going to make us cry? What?" I said, "Well, I'm going to do it all. But mostly, I'm going to try to keep the W's in the back row awake." So, without further ado, let's begin with the past. It all began so innocently. They put us in kindergarten, which we all know by now is nothing more than a disguise for school. They made us play for half a day, then they shipped us back home. Then they began to slowly increase the work and the time we spent there. Things got to be a little bit exhausting by the time fifth grade rolled around, but generally, life was governed by one simple rule: do as they want, or some enormously huge adult will make you do what they want. Try living by that rule nowadays in, say, senior social. Farm stands on Peterson's shoulders, you still got him by half an inch. After elementary school came middle school, which was invented just in time to keep us from being the oldest in the elementary school by kicking us into the junior high. Middle school is kind of a nice name for jungle warfare. Everybody grows up around you.
Except you.
I like to think of those years in my life as the dark, tragic years. Go back sometime and look at your eighth grade picture. Mine has become sort of a legend among horror stories of camera art. Come on, kids, sit still. Sit still. Hey, you want your picture to end up looking like this? Yeah, you better scream. Then we hit high school and kind of grew up. I remember the Twins winning the World Series. I remember the North Stars losing the Stanley Cup. Everything in between is kind of a blur. Except for Freedom Jam, of course. These past 4 years went by faster and faster. Then they were over. Well, that's all the farther I'm going to bring you on a trip down memory lane. I don't think I could do it justice. You don't need me to do that. You'll relive it time and time again for the rest of your lives. But before we can live the rest of our lives, we've got to get through tonight, which is, of course, the present. We're here, we're here, we're here. June the 5th, 1991. Everybody look around. I'm not going to have you shake hands with your neighbor. Look at the faces. Burn the images in your mind. Because this is the last time we'll all be together. Period. It'll be different for each of us who we run into. But I can guarantee you that there are going to be people here that you'll never see again. Yeah, everybody tells us that. I felt kind of obligated to say it. But even people we don't know all that well, it's still kind of sad to see them go. It's not so hard to leave, though, knowing that we have the memories to bring with us. Memories. There's a word for you. It's one thing adults tell us about high school. You're there to make memories to enjoy when you're old and decrepit like us. So what are you making? House payments. Oh. Well, then what are your memories from high school? I remember nothing. Memories. Probably flying through your head right now. Some of us are carrying away awards, honors, titles from high school. And even though those things will be with us the rest of our lives, I wonder if they'll mean as much to us as the memories we took away. I hope we can all remember the good times fondly and just learn to laugh at the bad times. You know, I've come to a conclusion these past few years. Let's just say, for the sake of argument now, that somebody's driving by the corner at the high school and somehow they tip their car over. Although I'd have to wonder about anybody who actually did it. Everybody will say to you, oh, you'll look back and laugh at it in a couple of years. The way I figure it, why not just laugh at it when it happens? Spare yourself some grief. Without bad things happening to us, we don't learn, we don't grow. If there were no such thing as unhappiness, then happiness couldn't exist either. Don't let your whole existence depend on being happy and successful every moment of every day. Some romances will be turning into memories in the next couple of months, which is just as well for some of them. We all know which ones I'm talking about. A day doesn't go by when I'm not innocently walking down the halls of Fridley High, and suddenly I stumble onto one of those public-private moments. You know, oh, yay, excuse me, sorry, pardon me. Don't mind me just using the halls for what they were designed for. I don't mean to make light of the end, whether it's with friends or romances. There are a lot of people that I wish I would have got to know better, but I didn't realize it until it was too late. I suppose deep down inside, we all have somebody we know that we'll never forget who got away. Whatever you do with your memories, don't go away angry. I know somebody out there who said, you know, they didn't care about anyone. They just wanted to get out of here. And I remember thinking how sad. How sad that things would ever get to the point where we don't even want to try to fix them. If there's something between you and someone else, take care of it tonight. We all make mistakes, sometimes huge errors. Forgive and forget and hope that people will do the same for you. Don't become one of those people who write into Dear Abby from San Diego saying they've been holding a grudge for 35 years. Plan tonight. Start planning right now. If you want to do something in life, figure out what you'll need to do and do it. Don't just wish for something and hope that it'll come true. Make it come true. If you're going to begin something, begin it now. Every day in middle school, we'd have something called homeroom. And in it, they'd always give us these worksheets on goals. Teacher would always loom over us asking, what's your goal? How are you going to get there? I always put escape homeroom. But now, I look back and I think, oh, wow, they were right. All that time, they were right. Maybe it was just an idea before its time. Back then, I was one of those kids described as a nervous wreck. I'm just glad I went to Fridley Middle School. Any place else, I never would have made it. Would have been dead in the water. Middle school years are just a horrible time in my life. Couldn't relate, couldn't cope, couldn't get my clothes to match. Didn't know what an adverbial clause was. I still don't know what an adverbial clause was. Never mind. Somewhere between 8th and 9th grade, as it did for a lot of us, something clicked. And I don't know what it was. Middle school probably claimed it was those dang worksheets. Everything kind of fell into place. I figured out a list of 5 major goals and numerous minor ones that I wanted to accomplish during high school. And I figured out what I'd need to do to reach them. Tonight finishes that list. because the last line was speak at commencement. I don't know exactly how, but it works. Trust me, it works. You want to win a Nobel Prize? Go do it. Get a doctorate? Go do it. Get rich, be a celebrity, tour the world, get married, be happy, become a major singing pop sensation that Lynette worships and set hotel rooms on fire? Go do it. Hope you cleaned out that locker, Lynette. Don't give explanations and excuses for your shortcomings. Quit thinking that you can't do it because your test scores are single digits, your GPA is a negative number, you're not all conference in 9 sports, including badminton. You have to ignore everything you've been taught by society. These things count for very little. They're indicators of success, but they don't determine it. To quote a song you've never heard of, it isn't practice, it isn't skill. They'll help, but not as much as wanting will. If you want something bad enough, you'll get it. That's one rule for the future. Now we're into the future part of the speech. Who can identify this? That's right, it's the Cliff Notes to Dickens' A Tale of Two Cities. Very good. This next one is a bit harder. Who can identify this? No, but you're close. It's the Cliff Notes for God's Life as We Know It in Modern America. Unfortunately, one of these titles doesn't exist. And we've all taken English Lit. We know which one exists. If the Guide to Life as We Know It in Modern America did exist, though, I think it would probably talk about the following things. Of course, this is just a guess. Number one, success is contentment. I see so many people who think that success is dependent on conforming to the in crowd. That's the second biggest lie in relating to success. The biggest one is the belief that success is having lots of money, being popular, having power. Success is nothing more than being happy with who you are and what you are. So who are the biggest losers in society? Rich, popular, powerful people who have realized that having everything in the world can't bring them happiness. Don't let the world tell you what you can and can't do. Stop the world, spin it backwards, tell it what to do. When I was younger, I wanted to be a U.S. Senator from Minnesota. Now I'm older, I've seen the reality of the world, how difficult and dangerous it is, and I want to be president. With Danforth J. Quayle as my running mate. Number two, look for the good in people, especially those who are often overlooked. We have a tendency in society to hero worship athletes, actors, celebrities, people with personality, funny people, intelligent people, Brian Engelson. Not necessarily in that order, Dr. Ng. You're on top, of course. But what about the people who slip by in silence? People whose achievements go unnoticed by the vast majority. People who overcome great odds to achieve in life. One example comes to mind. The many people who have lost parents or close family members who are graduating tonight. I have a lot of admiration for those people who are missing somebody and have gone on without them, because that's never happened to me. How many of us would actually recognize a genius or a saint in our presence? How many of us actually look at people and get to know them, really know them? How many of us look at people and say, there's more to them than meets the eye? We have got to learn to recognize these personal achievements and support them, to respect people for their love, honor, and integrity, not for superficial reasons. Number three, life is darned confusing. I don't think we'll ever figure life out, but that doesn't mean we can't keep on asking questions. Keep on wondering about life. Go outside on a starry night this summer and look up. I simply refuse to believe that all of this is just some sort of fluke, that life is here due to a series of 8 billion to 1 coincidences. I just can't. Keep on asking questions and realize what a thing life is. To quote famous playwright Thornton Wilder, do any human beings ever realize life while they live it? Every minute? No. Saints and poets, maybe. They do some. Realize it while it's here, before it's too late. Number four. There are times to think with your head, and times you have to go with your heart. We have to know when to use each one. And I suppose there will be times when we know we should think this one through, but every fiber of our being says, do it, take a risk. Realize that sometimes the consequences just aren't worth taking the risk. But sometimes life itself isn't worth not taking the risk. If you succeed, you succeed. If you fail, you fail. Be happy either way, because failure is a sign that you're still taking risks. Number 5, live a good and honest life. We all know people who have gone through their whole lives backstabbing people and betraying friends just to get what they want. They have this misconception that the real world respects a person who is willing to betray their conscience and feelings to get what they want. You know, by a funny coincidence, the biggest TV show of our time, Dallas, came on the air just as we entered kindergarten and exited just as we left our senior year. I wonder how many minds were affected by the views of that show. How many people honestly believe that ruthlessness is good? I guess I would only have one thing to say to these people and anyone like them. In the last episode, the main character of Dallas took his own life because after all he had done, he couldn't live with himself. I pity anyone who thinks that this is the way to go through life. Please, let your conscience be your guide. And finally, number 6, don't take any wooden nickels. No, I don't know what this means, but I think it's something like an adverbial clause. So this is it. I hope that you all realize the legacy we've left behind us as a class, one that may never be equaled in academics, athletics, the arts, not to mention personal grooming habits. Let the record show that we were a fine, fine class that graduated from one of the finest high schools in existence. I hope that no matter where you go or what you'll do, you'll never forget us. Never. I want to see every single person without exception at those class reunions. Don't worry about what you've been doing or what status symbols you can rent for the night. Just please, come back and say hi. I hope that someday we'll come back to Fridley High and see some high school kids working away to even surpass the goals and records we achieved. And I hope that we'll look down at them and say, if you think even for a second that you're going to be able to do what we did, then we're with you all the way. Support them just as we were supported. Because we're only the future of the world until the future is here. We've got to act fast. So much more to say. So many feelings within me saying, no, it can't be over. I've still got so much left to do. I see people who I never really got to say goodbye to, or apologize to, or simply to talk to. And I want to call out and scream, wait, I never knew you! I never knew you! Now we all just stand here and hope that they knew that we meant to say goodbye, that we meant to apologize, that we meant to talk. And I realized that there was nothing more that I could do. I'm just a part of the past here. Within a couple of years, people may not even remember we were here, but we did everything we could to carve our name into this place, and now it'll have to stand on its own. No more questions, no more feelings, no more. It is finished. Good luck, God bless, and remember, in the real world, you can go out for lunch every day and get away with it. Thank you.
Thanks, Ken Tendell, for those delightful remarks and for the $6.30. I appreciate it. After following student speakers up here for 10 years, I think that's an adverbial clause, incidentally. I've decided what the solution to the problem is. I'm going to ask Mr. Myers to change the order of speakers and put me before the student speaker in the future. It's my privilege this evening to perform two tasks. First, to introduce the school board to you, and then to make a few remarks to the graduating seniors. First, your school board, and if they would please stand and remain standing until I've introduced all of them, and then after I've introduced them all, I would ask you to join me in recognizing them. Mr. Jim Ferguson, chairman of the board. Mr. Kurt Schrupp, vice chairman. Mr. Gordon Backlund, director. Ms. Linda Huber, treasurer. Mr. David Newman, clerk. Mr. Gordon Sangster, director. Please join me in thanking them for their efforts on behalf of the Fridley School. I I might also comment that we have one board member who is retiring this year after 27 years on the board. Gordon Sangster is leaving the board as of July 1st. He certainly has made a significant contribution to these schools, and perhaps we owe him a special recognition this evening. Now to the seniors. You know, all senior classes seem to have some unique characteristic that makes them special or makes them memorable, and the class of 1991 is certainly no exception. They have for openers Kendall Heitzman in the class. The unique characteristic of this class, however, and Kendall has mentioned it, the unique characteristic that makes them special is indeed their high achievement. To give you this evening some sense of that high achievement, I'm going to list some of what this class has produced. Certainly I will miss some things, but I'm going to list some of the things that this class has produced. They have produced 20 presidential scholars. They have produced 2 national merit commended students. These are students in the top 5% of the students nationally. They've produced 5 national merit semifinalists. Those are students who are in the top 0.5% nationally. They've produced 4 national merit finalists. 73 of these students have a 3.0 grade point average or above. 32 of these students have a 3.5 grade point average or above. 6 of these students have a 3.9 grade point average or above, and they have a valedictorian with a 3.99 grade point average. In addition, the class of 1991 has produced 3 governor scholars, 30 students who have earned at least 5 college credits during their high school career, a state championship football team, an adapted soccer state consolation championship team, a conference championship in girls tennis, a Minnesota Miss Basketball finalist, 2 Eagle Scouts, a member of the All-State and academic All-State football teams, qualifiers for the state swimming and tennis tournaments, 2 state champions in computerized drafting, a cooperative district marching band that won the grand championship in the Washington, D.C. 4th of July Day Parade, a student representative on the Minnesota Academic Excellence League Council, the Chief Justice of the Minnesota Youth and Government Supreme Court, and the Reader Clerk of the Minnesota Youth and Government House of Representatives, the Region 5 AA winner of the State High School League Academics, Arts, and Athletics Award, an award-winning National Honor Society, and Minnesota's only member of the All-USA High School Academic Team. Indeed, the class of 1991 is a class of high achievers. Some of tonight's graduates who are seated before you this evening have contributed a great deal to this list of achievements, and some have not contributed as much. I think it's important to understand tonight, however, as we look at past achievements, that all people simply aren't ready to contribute at the same age, and they're not ready to contribute at the same time. There are some remarkable examples of that in our history, and I will list a few for you. Beethoven's music teacher said, for example, as a composer, he's hopeless. Einstein couldn't speak until the age of 4, and he couldn't read until he was 7 years old. Edison's teacher told him he's unable to learn. Caruso's music teacher told him that he had no voice at all. Leo Tolstoy flunked out of college. Louis Pasteur was given a rating of mediocre in chemistry at Royal College. Winston Churchill failed 6th grade. Walt Disney was fired by a newspaper editor because he had, and I quote, no good ideas. Henry Ford was evaluated as showing no promise, and Fred Waring once failed to get into his high school chorus. You could go on and on with examples, and while it's not in my notes, Kendall talked about some personal things, so I'll give you another personal example in a different category. Your superintendent was once a high school English teacher. When he was in 8th grade, he got a D in Mrs. Draham's 8th grade English class. Mrs. Boland will never let me live that down, and I'm sorry I let it out of the bag. But clearly, not everybody achieves early, and not everybody is immediately successful. The point tonight, however, is that we're counting on all of you 19, 91 graduates. We're counting not only on those of you who have already shown promise, we're counting on not only all of those of you who have already achieved great things, but we're counting on all of those of you who have not as well, because you all have capacity for great achievement. Parents, you first taught your children to walk, and now this evening comes the time to perform a much more difficult task, and that's to teach them to walk away. This is certainly important because they are grown and they're ready to get on with their lives. Seniors, I certainly congratulate you on your past achievements. You have done exceptionally well in your high school career. But more importantly, my best wishes for your every success and happiness in the future as you get on with your lives. Thank you very much.
Will the members of the class of 1991 please stand? Members of the Board of Education and Superintendent Renz, the members of this class have fulfilled all the requirements for graduation from this school as set forth by the State Board of Education and the Board of Education of the Fridley School District 14. In recognition of this achievement, they are entitled to their diplomas as graduates of Fridley High School. While you're standing, and I have one last moment, I too want to thank you on behalf of the faculty and myself personally for 4 wonderful years. We seek the cooperation of our guests this evening in withholding your applause and holding your cheers until the entire class has been presented. Chairman Ferguson, at this time, Dr. Ingvaldson and I will call the class of 1991 to the platform to receive their diplomas. Anders Anderson, Bradley Anderson, Heather Anderson, Michelle Anderson, Scott Anderson, Tamara Applin, Shirley Arnold, Michelle Basick, Hung Beck, Dawn Bass, Anna Batista, Anthony Batista, Jennifer Bender, Jill Bender, John Berglund, Brian Bergstrom, Stephen Bethel, James Bistrom, Richard Blair, Allison Blaska, Tammy Brodol, Todd Brown, Rhonda Buckman, Eva Bunkowski, Jessica Barrant, Michelle Burchette, Dominic Burkholder, Jason Burns, Craig Byersdorfer, Anthony Kane, John Cannon, Kimberly Carlson, Nicole Carlson, Corey Carney, Christine Castellejos, Barry Cedargrin, Jeannie Chase, Jay Christ, Jamison Psychos, Douglas Clare, Bernard Klein, Christina Klein, Matthew Cook, Kathy Cooper, Jody Crane, Jason Croteau, Catherine Daniels, Charles Dennis, Jason DeShaw, Michelle Dewing, Anthony DiCarlo, Andrew Devine, Melinda Dornbush, Christopher Douglas, Trafinia Eckberg, Michelle Eklund, Jennifer Eggerud, Jennifer Estling, Jeffrey Evans, Robert Ferguson, Julie Flegel, Jesse Fossum, James Gable, Toby Garber, Ann Gargaro, Timothy Jardine, Dustin Gilbert, Tracy Grendler, Catherine Haley, James Hansen, Sonia Heidelberger, Kendall Heitzman, Michael Hermanson, Tammy Hestra, Jeffrey Hill, Lynette Hilmes, Richard Hines, Michael Levinka, Jeffrey Hoskins, Angela House, Jeff Hootie, Federica Iba. Daniel Imberry. Kelly Janey. David Janiak. Eric Jensen. Cully Johnson. Denise Johnson. Kenneth Johnson. April Jones. Darcy Kazmarczyk. Aaron Koth. Joanna Kepka. Zachary Klink. Matthew Klinsing. Jason Knudsen. Colleen Coring. Jennifer Cossie. James Kraling. Candace Krenz. Rachel Cupp. Marie Kurtz. Stephen LaFond. James Lawrence. Robert Leach. Derek LeBrasser. Jason Lindquist. Jennifer Loberg. Judy Lange. Jeffrey Lorch. Heidi Moss. Elisa Marchafava. Marcus Martin. Marcus. Terry Martinson. Joey Matson. Walter Messer. Christopher Muhorter. Mark Maholsky. Michelle Miskowick. Kari Moan. Jennifer Mormon. Randall Mucky. Nancy Myers. Thomas Mervang. Grace Naraki. Michael Nelson. Daniel Newport. Tung Nguyen. Jessica Nick. Scott Neiman. Jennifer Nolby. Troy Nordland. Randolph Nussbaum. Chad Olson. Krista Owens. Christine Pestones. Alden Patton. Ryan Peterson. Tina Picat. Amy Porath. Young Payan. Einar Rasmussen. Leanne Rohde. Jeannie Rodemeyer. Eric Rohr. Heidi Rolick. Claudia Rosales. Amy Rusinick. Robert Saba. Rebecca Salmonson. Matthew Salo. Brett Schmidt. Paul Sapansky. Corey Severson. Kimberly Severson. Jennifer Sharp. Benjamin Shaw. Ginger Shagstead. Jennifer Shelton. Lydia Shimon. Bradford Sims. Raymond Sombrio. Jason Stallman. Andrew Stevens. Daniel Stilson. Aaron Stone. Christopher Stromdahl. Roger Taylor. Blaine Tatro. Brett Tollickson. Sonia Traverse. Tina Turnage. Theodora Van Heersley. Lisa Verdon. Darlene Verkus. Brian Welshans. Daniel Winthy. Jenny White. Dennis Weiberg. Rebecca Wisniewski. Ann Witkowski. Jason Wolf. Thank you, and please join me in saluting the class of 1991.
Thank you. Please stand. Loving God, you have created a wide and wonderful world. Bless all of us. Open the road for us with beauty and adventure. Bless all of us. Keep us from harm and evil, and send us escorts full of hope and goodness. Bless all of us. May our hearts be wrapped in wonder, and our eyes focused on a mystic map of our future and your plan. Bless all of us. Shield us from all harm, and bring us all to safety and peace. Bless all of us.